Hello, my YouTube friends. I hope your week is just every blessing you've ever wanted it to be. And if it's not, you know what? I hope it gets better soon. My name is Joel. And one thing that has actually been pretty close to my heart is mental health. And we got a question on our YouTube channel asking, you know, what happens when you're struggling with mental health issues and you find it really hard to pray and it's impacting our spirituality? Fleur Your Heart asked that question. And I think it's a brave question to ask. And I really appreciate it because I don't think in our spiritual religious circles, we necessarily ask that question as much as we should. In fact, culturally, we don't ask that question as much as we should. We don't bring up the topic of mental health outside of particular awareness campaigns or Mental Health Awareness Month because it's tough to talk about. And so I think asking the question is brave, and I think looking for an answer is important. It's important to me because as somebody who's wrestled with depression and anxiety, I've thought a lot about what it means to be a person of faith, but also to go through dark times that aren't necessarily spiritually related. Of course, in our spiritual life, there are times that are up and down, but mental health is different and it can impact our spiritual life. But it's really important to know that it is not because necessarily of our spiritual life. So if you find yourself wrestling with those things, I want to just give you a couple things that have really been impactful for me to consider, especially when it comes to struggling with mental health and with prayer. You know, the first thing is mental health, anxiety, depression, mental health disorders. They are a medical condition and they require medical treatment. If you broke your arm, you wouldn't look at me and say, man, I broke my arm, and then I'd say, hey, you know what, let me pray over that for a minute. I'd certainly want to pray with you while I drove you to a hospital to go see a doctor who could do something to fix your arm. I think sometimes we really reduce mental health issues to something that we could just pray away, and that's not always the case. It's important to absolutely be rooted in prayer, but also to go see people who have been trained to help us, counselors, therapists, doctors. All of those types of people have been really beneficial to me. Now, that's important to do if you find yourself struggling in prayer, because sometimes we can't fix our spiritual life as well as we could if our physical life is still a little bit broken. So we want to make sure that we're fixing the physical part, the nature of our body, before we really start to build on the spiritual piece, so we have a solid foundation in which to do that. The second thing is this: if you find yourself wrestling, you're not doing anything wrong. If you're struggling with depression or anxiety and you feel distant from God in prayer, you feel like you're just not getting it, remember that God is still close to you. One of my favorite scripture passages is from the book of Psalms. Psalms 34:18 says, God is close to the brokenhearted. He saves those whose spirit is crushed. That means that when we're struggling and we feel broken, God's really, really close to us, and he's really, really close to you in those moments of anxiety, of depression, of mental struggle. So remember that God's not far from you, even if your mind is telling you that God's abandoned you, that God is not with you, that it's hopeless, that you're worthless. All of those things are untrue. And you need to speak back into those things and say, I feel maybe that I'm worthless, but God says I'm worth something. And that means it's worth fighting for me to become healthier. And the other thing is, if you have somebody who's a friend who's wrestling with this, you're not, but you know that they are, be supportive of them, but don't try to fix them. I think sometimes when people share with us, hey, I'm really struggling in my prayer life, I feel depressed, I feel anxious, we want to throw a diagnosis at them and we want to say, well, here's how you should pray harder to feel something. Here's what you should do to get happier. And the reality is, what people are looking for when we're struggling with mental illness is somebody to walk with. And as that person, we can also point them towards people who have more expertise than we do as counselors and therapists, spiritual directors even, to help them out. It takes a team of people sometimes to help us become healthy. And you know what? That's completely fine. So if you find yourself struggling in prayer because you're wrestling with mental illness, anxiety, and depression, you're finding it's impacting your spiritual life, go find somebody who can help you talk through those things. Keep praying, stay faithful. The Lord has not abandoned you. And if you know somebody who's wrestling with those things, be a friend, be a companion, be somebody who listens with them on the journey. If you know somebody who's struggling with this, go ahead and share this video with them. Give it a like and subscribe to our YouTube channel. And come back here every single week for more content just like this. I'll see you then.